very nice.
UAB orthopedic surgeon Brent Ponce is on the phone with a colleague in Atlanta. They are looking over some images prior to Ponce performing a shoulder surgery in Birmingham. That extra hand belongs to the Atlanta doctor, Pani Dantaluri. It's telemedicine with a twist.
It's real time, real life right there, as opposed to a normal Skype or normal video conference call, which is just back and forth dialogue, but it's not really interactive.
And it's right there in the operating room, using a virtual reality technology developed at UAB called VIPAAR, along with Google Glass. The camera in the Google Glass sends an image of the surgical field to Dantaluri's computer in Atlanta. He sees what Ponce sees, and VIPAAR allows him to reach into the virtual field in real time. In turn, Ponce sees Dantaluri's hands and instruments in his Google Glass heads-up display.
A surgeon, a remote surgeon, is able to put his hands or her hands into the surgical field and provide assistance to point out different structures, the anatomy, the placement of retractors. So it's a safety net to improve patient care by having that assistance from an expert who's not in the room.
Ponce and Dantaluri teamed up for this first ever VIPAAR Google Glass operation. It's a good way to teach surgical residents or allow a veteran surgeon like Ponce to serve as a mentor.
When you have residents graduate or an attending who's on staff somewhere else is learning a new procedure and would want help or assistance for the first 2, 3, 4, 5, 10, this system is able to provide the help, but then also they acquire the skills and the education while they're doing the procedure.
It's exporting expertise.
UAB neurosurgeon Bart Guthrie has often advised less experienced surgeons at small regional hospitals about difficult cases over the telephone. What a difference, he thought, if he could show and not just tell.
So if we could actually get our hands and guide a surgeon who has the skill but not the experience, that could be a life and death difference.
10 years in the making, Guthrie teamed up with UAB's mechanical engineering department to create the VIPAAR technology. Besides telemedicine, VIPAAR CEO Drew Deaton says applications include the field service industry, whether it's repairing a home air conditioning unit or a factory assembly line.
It's like being there side by side with someone when you might be 1,000 miles or 10,000 miles away. I can't imagine 5 years from now being able to use a smartphone or other device to not connect to the expert to solve my problem and have that person reach in and show me how to solve that problem, because the technology is advancing rapidly and we're bringing this capability to market today.